The whole science, there's a science behind it, you know? No, no, nada es por casualidad.
Mm-hmm. Well, and that's what I love about business. I mean, once you master it, I mean, you realize it's not about luck.
No,
it's
never.
About knowing the recipe and putting it to work.
Hey, everybody. So I have here a special guest. For me, it's kind of hard to get starstruck. I've met with a lot of people. And kind of, I see them as human beings because I know they are. But for the first time, I can't believe that you're literally sitting in front of me because I've seen your content for so much. It has given me so much value. I study a lot of the Grant Cardones and the Gary Vaynerchuks, all these business people that, you know, but I can never relate to them. And when I found you about a year and a half ago, I'm not gonna lie, look, se me enchinó la piel.
Oh.
Like, I started devouring your content. I devoured your podcast in one day.
Wow.
I keep devouring your content, and the main reason is because I could apply it. So I'm applying it in my business, and because of that, you've given me so many gold nuggets. So I wanted to introduce you, Carlos Marquez, to my community.
Well, thank you very much for the invitation. It's like being back at home.
Yeah, you're from here, right?
I grew up in San Pedro, California, so being here in Paramount, are we?
Yeah.
It's like my backyard, so I'm happy. Currently, I live in Mexico City for business, but yeah, I grew up here. You know, I grew up here in San Pedro, California. My parents are from Zacatecas as well, and I fell in love with business. I fell in love with business, and I discovered business because I saved money a través de una cundina, una tanda. You know, you sign up, and you give your tía $30, and she gives you a number, and eventually she gives you back your money. So it's like a forced loan, prepaid loan. So once I got that money, I saved it, and I went to downtown LA. And I went to downtown LA, and I felt like the richest person on earth, 13 years old, with $300. I was helping a man set up his stand at a swap meet, Harbor College swap meet, and I saw how much money he was making, so my natural process was to, hey, I'm gonna invest this and I'm gonna start selling. So I learned business. I saw that the art of business is very, very easy. I'm dyslexic. I sucked at school. I dropped out when I was 14 years old. So I learned that, hey, if I invest a dollar, I can turn it into $3, and I fell in love with that concept. And I've been putting that in practice since the age of 13, and it's never failed me. So that's what's worked for me. And I built, I went from the SWAT meet, and then I started a franchise company. I started an income tax office. I took that course, and I learned income tax. And actually, people think that I did it for the money. I remember my dad is, you know, that macho Mexican with a big heart, though. And I remember one time we went to a tax preparation office, and they screwed up his tax return.
Oh.
And he kept going back, and he kept going back, and the ladies wouldn't help him. They oh, yeah, le llegó una carta, yeah, don't worry, don't worry. And I remember one time I saw my dad show up before he would get home from work, and he was red in the face with tears in his eyes, and he had gotten a wage garnishment to where they were going to take away his paycheck because he hadn't paid this debt. And I remember that's kind of when I saw that H&R Block ad, I said, hey, I'm going to do this because I remember my dad, you know, going through a situation like this. And I did it because I wanted to help people. So I opened up an income tax office. I ended up back at the swap meet because I found out that the secret to business is to be in front of people.
Yeah.
So I set up a stand, but now instead of selling cosmetics as a kid, I had a table full of candy, and then I would invite the parents to come and get candies for the kids, and I would talk about income tax. So that income tax office grew over a decade, and I ended up with 198 income tax offices.
Wow.
I founded my own bank. At one point, I had a bank. I was a partner of a bank, and I sold it a couple years ago. And ever since, I said, I'm gonna take some time off. And when I returned to the age of 40, when I turned 40, I would go back into business, and that's what I'm doing now.
Like right now, business is not easy. We're in the middle of it, Charosteca scaling. And you know, when the business is scaling, it drains cash, it drains energy, it drains everything.
Everything.
Yeah, but now that I'm thinking, like even what we went through last week or last month or last year or 2 years, 3 years ago, those are my nicest memories. Mm-hmm. Like for you, were there a lot of times where you remember like, man, I wanted to throw in the towel, but I'm so grateful I didn't?
Mm-hmm. Well, I think I failed, and I tell people, because people sometimes say, oh, you own this or you have this. And I said, the only reason I have more is because I failed more than you have. That's the only reason. So I think now at the moment it hurts. It hurts when you lose. It hurts when the uncertainty, you know, But at this point, I look at those moments of huge ahas, and I wouldn't change them for anything in the world, you know? And it's so funny because people look at you and they say, well, everything that you do works out. I said, no, there was a whole period in my life where it was trial and error.
Yeah.
So now at my 40s, my late 30s, you know, I can make a lot better decisions just because I have that experience, but it comes out of failing.
Yeah, and that comes to me too, where I failed so many times and I love failing. It's weird, but I love to make mistakes. Mm-hmm. And that's one of the things that, for me, I don't have the fear of like, yeah, judge me if you want, but right. For me, I will find a way.
To do it, yeah.
Yeah, and I will find a way.
But that's literally what I do. I love giving people jobs, and I tell my employees, you will never get rich by the amount of money that you're gonna make from me, but you will get rich if you put into practice what I do and what you learn through me. So there is no hay egoísmo.
No.
I tell my employees, learn from me as much as you can because I might wake up on the wrong side of the bed and fire you tomorrow. But so just learn, and it's so powerful. Where one of my first franchisees, maybe 10, 15 years ago, came to one of my events recently to a public talk that I did, and he said, I made a commitment to myself to look for you when I would make my first $1 million. And you know, and I'm here to thank you because I've made my first $1 million.
Wow.
And because of you, and I'm like, that's so powerful, right? And that's even, that gets me more excited than that. I think sometimes when I achieve a sales goal,
yeah,
to know that you empowered others, I think, I believe in that. If you help other people do, you know, great things.
If you help enough people get what they want, universe is going to help you get what you want.
Well,
I haven't confessed this anywhere, not even to my sister, which is here, but you made another millionaire with somebody that's right in front of you right now on the mic, and you put your granito de arena. So just so you know, like, and I want to thank you for that.
Oh, well, thank you.
Because you cannot give me everything in the palm of my hand, you know, but you could just give me an opportunity. Like my parents gave me the opportunity to be born here. That's all someone could give me.
Right.
Me dieron la oportunidad. Pero tú también me estás dando algo más, que no me estás dando el billete o no me estás dando aquí, déjame enseñarte, pero me estás dando consejos. And tú no me conocías y yo no te conozco. But just know that in there, the universe, hay la sinergia.
Mm-hmm.
Que tú me ayudaste a mí. So now put another one on your checklist.
Oh, well, so, thank you.
Yeah. And what I want to go to.
Honor.
The honor is mine. Mm-hmm. One of the things I want to talk to you about is you put a post today on your story. It's a quote.
Okay.
I really want to talk about that because there's a deeper meaning to it. Because a lot of people are looking for advice. Mm-hmm. Que mira mi primo que es panadero, mm-hmm, me dijo que invirtiera en la propiedad y me dijo que acá que
yeah,
right? Like el consejo más caro es el consejo gratis. Y a veces es del familiar.
Yeah.
Y como dijo, do you remember the quote that you put today?
Un jodido no puede ayudar a otro jodido, right? Jodido, yeah. Sometimes we listen to that person who we shouldn't be listening,
yeah,
to. Un jodido no puede ayudar a otro jodido. So what does that mean? We lead by example. And I think that one needs to all follow by example. And I think people are always great to give advice. Pero el problema es that they don't have the results to back it up,
yeah,
you know? And I always have given out your account. Sigan a Charro Azteca. You guys want to see how to do a correct Instagram? Sigan a Charro Azteca, right? Pero como vendo por, you know, and, you know, because we see that whole philosophy, and I admire the fact of what your team has done with your Instagram. It's just amazing. It's beautiful.
Thank
o sea,
you.
Tú ingresas a Charro Azteca y te sientes orgulloso de ser mexicano. Y de casualidad, people are buying your products.
Yeah.
And that's the art of selling. There's so many things that we can do. And I think there is a little bit of delay. There is delay. I see it now that I live in Mexico. U.S. hits first, and then it's Mexico City. But there is delay even here in our own country.
Yeah.
Yes, here. I mean,
within the Latino community.
Within the Latino community. So I think that this decade, it's the decade if we utilize technology, if we utilize lo que está a nuestro alcance, we can do great things.
Yeah.
I mean, I think I needed to have opened 200 offices to do what I did. And that was like traditional business. Today, if I was starting, I mean, I would have a warehouse space,
yeah,
like you have a warehouse space, and I would have a website. So you're onto something great. And I think that's the opportunity that we have.
Yeah.
I stopped doing conferences and seminars. I only do nonprofits because I have that philosophy of, hey, you don't have to pay to see me speak, just, you know, whatever. So, but I do try to document as much as I can of what I do a little bit with my businesses. It's a little bit hard because I travel so much, but we're getting better at that. But right now, I'm really focused on creating brands that emphasize the Hispanic heritage. I love that my new cosmetic line is called Macaria. It's a very Mexican name.
Yeah.
very Mexican, and we love it. I didn't bring you samples. I'm gonna send your sister some samples. But you know, it has the azulejo design. It has, you know, the bordado design. I mean, it's something like,
that's cool.
Awesome. It's beautiful. And Macaria is my aunt's name. So it's honor. And I think that it's time. I think our parents had it so difficult when they first came because, you know, they were the first ones.
Yeah.
They were the real dreamers, as you said in your post the other day. And I think now, us, my second generation, you know, I think now it's a huge opportunity, and we don't want to see everything to come from China. We don't want to see every, you know, MAC puts something, Selena, now it's Mexican cosmetic. You know, los Mexicanos están de moda just because they put Chile on something, you know? So I think we're the ones who can carry this torch, and we're the ones who could maximize it. It's our opportunity. And our parents, you know, opened the way to make this happen.
What would you tell yourself, or what would you tell the listeners if you were 18 years again?
I think it's my recipe for taking action. I think, you know, the first thing you gotta do with yourself is stop living in a bubble. Don't over-exaggerate your circumstances. It's just being planet reality. We're experts, los Latinos, and we live in a telenovela. You know, we live in a telenovela. So when it's bad, it's bad. And when it's great, we forget reality. So numero uno is planet reality. Tienes que estar consciente that your reality. Sometimes we forget that. If you're having a difficult situation, it's not the end of the world. There's somebody out there who is living a far greater, worse circumstance than you are. And if you think you're okay, you know, no caigas en el conformismo, right? So number two is you have to have a vision. And I think sometimes we forget our vision because we get married. We forget our vision because, you know, we're wrapped up with our kids. No, you have to, tienes que mantener your vision. And then three, you have to set up, program your GPS. Yeah. Tienes que saber para dónde vas. So that's the problem. There's a lot of people who talk big, but what are you gonna do? Well, I don't know. You know, and I talk about 98% of the population complains about what they're living, mm-hmm. but when you ask them, entonces qué? Well, I don't know. You know, it's Trump's fault. No, it's not Trump's fault. You know, when Obama was here, you were still screwed up, right? So you have to have a plan. So what is your plan? I'm sure you followed a plan. Yeah. Maybe, and it's not perfect.
No.
Pero con que te enfoques en cuál va a ser tu próximo paso. Start con lo que está a tu alcance.
Yeah.
And if you need money to take your next step, you are never going to do anything.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I think it's so great you're doing this podcast. That's why I really rooted for you, because indirectamente, directly, you're going to be a model for a lot of people, you know, to do, because they're going to get inspired because you are like us, Espanol, Inglés, you know, perfecto. And we're going to inspire a whole new generation, you know,
nice.
I know, and I commend you for that. So that's what I would tell people. Find yourself, encuentra alguien that sounds like you, talks like you, and has done it. Y pégateles como un chicle y no los dejes ir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Ahí ponme en tu lista. At least know that you have inspired somebody. And I'm hoping that with this podcast, there's going to be a lot of people that I don't know and they don't know us. But they're going to take something from this podcast. And I'm just hoping that they run with it.
Impact. We're gonna, impact. That's our goal. Impact a lot of Latino lives out there.
Carlos, muchas gracias.
Gracias.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
Gracias. It was awesome.